بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I wish you once again a Ramadan Mubarak and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may these days and nights of Ramadan be a blessing for all of us inshallah Amin Ya Rabbil Alameen As we begin these middle 10 nights of Ramadan, we are reminded by the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam where he says, أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةُ وَأَوْسَطُهُ مَغْفِرَةُ وَآخِرُهُ عِتْقٌ مِّنَ النَّارِ The first portion is that of the mercy of Allah. The middle portion is that of the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the final one is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection from the hellfire. So as we begin these middle 10 nights of Ramadan, let us remind ourselves that in addition to everything that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, per the recommendation of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, maghfirah, forgiveness is something that we ask for increasingly within these 10 nights. And as I had mentioned that hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam last week, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was climbing the pulpit, he said Ameen three times and essentially reminded us that attaining forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so easy and one of the greatest things that we need to do in the month of Ramadan and that if we don't do it, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has prayed against or Jibreel has prayed against that individual and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has said Ameen to it. So what I would like to do is a share a verse or two of the Qur'an and a few traditions and a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Imran reminds us and says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, hasten, race, run towards the forgiveness of your Lord. وَسَارِعُوا مُسَارَعَةً Right, go really quickly إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ towards the forgiveness of your Lord وَجَنَّةٍ and towards gardens عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ the width of which or the span of which is the heavens is equivalent to the heavens and the earth. In other words, Jannah is much larger than the heavens and the earth and run towards it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ What is this Jannah? It has been prepared for the muttaqeen, for those who are God conscious. Then Allah mentions a few qualities here and I'll go through them. Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ Who are the muttaqeen? These are people who spend in prosperity and adversity. In other words, they spend when times were good and they spend even when times are difficult. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ And these are people who hold on to their anger. They repress their anger. They're really angry. They're in a position where they can actually be angry at another individual and despite that, they hold back. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ And they forgive people. They forgive people, right? If you forgive others, Allah will forgive you. There's that hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam where he says, إِرْحَمُوا مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمْكُمْ مَن فِي السَّمَاءِ Have mercy on the people of the face of this earth and the one in the heavens will have mercy on you. Right? If we forgive for the sake of Allah, Allah will forgive us, inshallah. That's the greatest reward that we can benefit from, that we can expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we forgive others. Then Allah continues, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ Allah loves those who do good. Now listen to the next verse. Allah says, Who are the muttaqeen? Allah is still describing the qualities of the muttaqeen. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً The muttaqeen are people who, when they commit an evil, when they make a mistake, when they commit a sin, أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ Or they oppress against themselves. In other words, you do something that you shouldn't have. Dhakarullah. They remember Allah. You know, they make that mistake. You've made a mistake. It's not like we haven't. We've sinned. But then what do? Dhakarullah. They remember Allah. Ya Allah. Right? In prayer. Either we remember Allah in prayer. We remember Allah in dhikr. We remember Allah through salawat. However it is that we remember. Dhakarullah. Fastaghfaru lidhunubihim. And The muttaqeen are the people who make istighfar of their sins, who seek forgiveness of their sins, right? We say, Ya Allah, forgive me. However it is that we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this is the part. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Who is there to forgive sins except Allah? Who has the authority to forgive sins except Allah? Who has the ability to forgive except Allah? In other words, there's no one that can forgive any wrongdoing that we do except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is reminding us that seek forgiveness from me and I will forgive you. And in addition to my forgiveness, I will give you paradise. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ And they do not persist on the actions that they used to do. أُولَٰئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ Allah then once again reminds us of the rewards. He says, these are the people, the reward for them is مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ Right, forgiveness from their Lord. وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ And gardens, paradise, underneath which rivers flow. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا They will be in there forever. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ And what a beautiful return and reward this is for those who do actions, for those who do good. There's another place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we talk about forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا Right? This is in Surah Nur. Allah says, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا Let them forgive, let them pardon, let them forgive, and let them overlook. وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا What does overlooking mean? Overlooking means that you happen to be in a position where you can get your revenge, where you can get your return. Despite that, you say, you know what? For the sake of Allah, until the day of judgment, until I go into paradise, you've been forgiven. And I'm not going to bring it up again. Now, of course, you know, there's times and places if the instance is that of harm and you want to bring it to the attention of any individual or that individual, that's understood. But, you know, sometimes someone has done some wrong to you and you just, and it's really not going to make a difference. You just end up forgiving them. وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا Then Allah continues, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Would you not love that Allah would forgive you? أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Would you not love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive you? I want to share a few ahadith. Forgiveness. Remember, we're talking about the middle 10 days of Ramadan and forgiveness. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Man lazim al This is such a beautiful hadith. Man lazim al istighfara, ja'ala Allahu lahu min kulli dhiqin makhraja wa min kulli hammin faraja wa razaqahu min haythu la yahtasib. This is not just for Ramadan. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, whosoever makes istighfar constantly. And I'm not, this by the way doesn't mean that you pull out a tasbih every day and say astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. No. While that's part of it. This doesn't necessarily just mean that after the prayer we say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah three times as we are reminded in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No, this just means constantly seeking istighfar. You do something wrong, you think of something wrong, and you say, Ya Allah, forgive me. In your heart, with your tongue, you say, Ya Allah, forgive me. You think of something else, you say, Ya Allah, forgive me. You saw something that you know you shouldn't have seen, you say astaghfirullah, or say, Allah, forgive me. You hear something that might, not haram, but just might be doubtful, you say, Ya Allah, please forgive me, I promise not to do it. In other words, is in a constant state of istighfar, consciously remembering and thinking of the things that might be wrong, man lazim al-istighfar, constantly seeking forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises three things for that individual. جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِن كُلِّ ضِيقٍ مَخْرَجًا Allah will appoint a way out of every distress for that individual. Anything that worries you, Allah will appoint a way out of that. And a relief from every anxiety. وَمِن كُلِّ هَمٍ فَرَجًا A relief from every anxiety. You know you're in a difficulty, you're in a bind, you don't know how to get out of this. Make istighfar, Allah will pull you out of it. You're worried about something, you can't go to sleep at night. Make istighfar, Allah will create an opening, right? Allah will grant you relief from every anxiety. وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide sustenance from where they least expected it. Imam Abu Dawood narrates this. Another hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, whosoever says, Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh, I seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one without whom there's none worthy of worship except him, alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum, ever living, all sustaining, wa atubu ilayh, and I make tawbah to him, and I repent to him. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, غَفَرْتُ. This is, by the way, a hadith Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, actually, I apologize, this is not a hadith Qudsi. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that his sins will be forgiven. وَإِن كَانَ قَدْ فَرَّ مِنَ الزَّحْفِ. Even if this individual would have run away from a battlefield. Even if this individual would have run away. Running away from the battlefield is considered to be one of the major sins. You know, when we talk about major sins, shirk is a major sin. Disobedient to parents is a major sin. Usury is a major sin. Usurping the wealth of orphans or anyone else's wealth is a major sin. Running away from a battlefield is a major sin. The Nabi alayhi salam says, if you simply say, Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh, Allah would forgive all your sins, even if it was a major one. And I want to close with another hadith. Anas radiallahu anhu says that I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam who said, قال الله تعالى, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. This is a hadith Qudsi. يَبْنَ آدَمْ. O son of Adam, O son of Adam, إِنَّكَ مَا دَعَوْتَنِي وَرَجَوْتَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَكَ مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. I shall go on forgiving you as long as you pray to me and aspire for my forgiveness, whatever your sins may be. As long as you pray to me and don't pray to anyone else, and as long as you aspire for forgiveness from me and no one else, I shall continue to forgive you whatever your sins may be, right? مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي, it doesn't matter to me. يَبْنَ آدَمْ, O son of Adam, لَوْ بَلَغْتَ ذُنُوبَكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. O son of Adam, I do not care, it doesn't matter to me if your sins should pile up to the sky and you seek forgiveness from me, I would forgive you. In other words, even if your sins are so much that anana sama, they pile up all the way to the sky, ghafartu laka wala ubali, I would forgive you and it wouldn't matter to me. Allah says it wouldn't make a difference to me you can't take anything away from me by my forgiving you. It won't decrease in anything that I have. It's very simple for me to do. And then the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues, يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِنَّكَ لَوْ أَتَيْتَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَا ثُمَّ لَقِيتَنِي لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرَةً. O son of Adam, if you come to me with an earth full of sins and meet me, come to me on the day of judgment or in this world, come to me with an earth full of sins and meet me, not associating anything with me in partnership. In other words, not having made any shirk. I will certainly grant you as much pardon as that fills the earth. In other words, you brought an earth full of sins to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you did not seek, you did not make any shirk, and you sought Allah's forgiveness, Allah would return that much back to you in forgiveness. Brothers and sisters, as I mentioned earlier, we're going through the middle 10 days of Ramadan, and of course the entire month of Ramadan, and we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter who we are, no matter what we've done, no matter what sin we might have committed in the past. Let us seek these nights to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make tawbah to Him to the best of our ability. Promise Allah that we won't commit that sin again. But at the very least, seek forgiveness for that which has been done in the past. No matter how major or minor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting and standing, our prayers and everything that we do in Ramadan, and make the rest of Ramadan an easy one for us, insha'Allah. Barakallahu feekum, jazakumullahu khairan, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.